Filipinas lawmakers extend the suspension of Negros Oriental Representative Arnolfo Tepes Jr. They also imposed a new penalty on their colleague who refuses to return to the country to face murder allegations. Archie Cruz reports.
Voting 285-01, the House of Representatives suspended Negros Oriental 36 Representative Arnolfo Tevez Jr. for the second time for disorderly behavior since he remains overseas without the blessings of the chamber. The plenary adopted the Committee on Ethics and Privileges recommendation to impose a suspension in addition to stripping him off all committee memberships. Tevez Jr. is vice chairman of the Committee on Games and Amusements and a member of the Committees on Legislative Franchises and Nuclear Energy.
As the guardian of the moral foundation of our institution, the committee exercises its authority to recommend any action or remedial measures that will vindicate the authority and dignity of the House of Representatives. The acts of Representative A. Tevez Jr. cast serious doubts upon his ability to maintain the trust and perform his duties with integrity and uprightness.
Rizal, First District Representative Jack Duabit, appealed to his colleague to come home, calling his vote to suspend Tevez Jr. a lifeline. Duabit explained the gravity of Tevez Jr.'s act of applying for political asylum overseas.
But basically, in the United Nations, then all over the world, by definition, when you apply for refugee status, when you apply for political asylum, you are making the accusation that your country does A, not have the capability to offer protection for those persecuted, or that your own country is unwilling to provide protection for the persecuted. But worst of all, it also implies may also imply that your very own country, your very own government, is the perpetrator of such persecution. These are accusations that are so grave. I'd like to take this time, Mr. Speaker, to make a plea to our colleague, Representative Arnie Tevez. Perhaps he was misadvised. Perhaps he did not see that by applying in Timor-Leste that this was the accusation that he has brought on our state.
Speaker Martin Romualdez is designated as the legislative caretaker of the district, while Tevez Jr. is suspended from May 31 to July 30, 2023. Tevez has been tagged as the alleged mastermind in the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
In other news, five more suspects in the murder of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo recant their statements, but the Justice Department is still confident it has an airtight case against the supposed mastermind, suspended lawmaker Arnolfo Tevez Jr. Jeffrey Hernandez reports.
Five more suspects in the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo recanted their previous testimonies before the Manila Regional Trial Court. The latest set of suspects to recant are Joric Labrador, Benji Rodriguez, Winrich Esturiz, Eloyo Gonyon Jr., and John Louis Gonyon. Their lawyer says they were tortured and coerced to admitting to the crime.
That's not voluntary.
10 out of 11 suspects have already recanted their testimonies. The remaining suspect, Congressman Arnolfo Tevez's aide Marvin Miranda, has nothing to recant, for he has not yet submitted any testimony. The court meanwhile deferred the arraignment of the suspects due to the motions filed. These include the motions to dismiss the case, suppress the evidence, and remand the case back to the Department of Justice. The suspect's camp says they were illegally arrested.
Kung hindi naman sila involved, illegal yung pag-aresto sa kanila. Hindi rin sila na-aresto na nahuli sa akto na gumawa ng krimen. So hindi ano yon, in flagrante delicto arrest. Hindi rin arrest yun na pursuant to hot pursuit. Sapagkat hindi naman sila ang subject ng sinasabing manhunt operation.
Because of the recantations, lawyer Ferdinand Topacio believes there is no more direct evidence against the lawmaker.
Definitely, kung magre-recant sila, walang magiging direct evidence against Congressman Tevez, which is what we have been saying all along. Yung sinasabi na 99.9% so tuloy na ang boxing, those things were done precipitately. And in order to subject my client to trial by publicity and demonize him.
But Justice Department Chief Jesus Crispin Remulla says otherwise.
Marami tayong evidence na iba. May independent physical evidence tayo. May circumstantial evidence. That recantations will not defeat the case of the government. That the government is doing this for the Filipino people, not for a rich individual who, of course, is a gambling lord.
Meanwhile, Remulla confirmed that Tevez is still in Timor-Leste together with some family members. The lawmaker's visa was also extended after asking Timor-Leste Supreme Court to reconsider his petition for asylum. Jeffrey Hernaez, ABS-CBN News.
Negros Oriental Governor Guido Reyes has passed away. He died just over 2 months since he took over the post from his slain predecessor, Ruel Degamo. The provincial administrator says Reyes was battling a terminal illness and died in a hospital in Metro Manila. No other details were given. Vice Governor Manuel Sagarabia has been sworn in as the new governor of the province. Another Philippine journalist is murdered. Radio broadcaster Crescenciano Bundukin was shot dead by two gunmen Wednesday outside his home in Calapan City. One of the suspects was killed after Bundukin's son rammed the motorcycle they were riding on. Bundukin had been outspoken about the oil spill that affected Oriental Mindoro, as well as on political issues. He's the third journalist killed under the Marcos administration, and his death comes less than a year after veteran broadcaster Percy Lapid was ambushed and killed. Philippine lawmakers swiftly approved a controversial bill to create a sovereign wealth fund. The bicameral committee swept aside persistent criticism of the president's pet measure to pass it before Congress adjourns its session. Sharon Torres has the full story.
Majority bloc members in the Senate and the House of Representatives were able to beat the last day of session before its sine die adjournment and successfully adopted the bicameral conference committee report of the Maharlika Investment Fund Act of 2023, which is now considered as an enrolled bill. It will be soon submitted to the President for its signing into law. The adoption was made during the Wednesday session or hours after Chamber representatives held a 20-minute bicameral conference meeting in Makati City Wednesday morning, with congressmen adopting the full Senate version. On Tuesday, senators held a marathon session before approving the bill on third and final reading. Senator Risa Ontiveros was the only senator who voted against the Maharlika Fund bill during the Wednesday dawn session, since her ally Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel III was no longer around when the voting took place. Senator Nancy Binay abstained, while Senators Amy Marcos and Chiz Escudero, who did not participate in the voting, maintained that their act was also equivalent to a no vote. Still, some senators made sure that workers' pension funds will remain safe amid the existence of the Maharlika Fund.
After the word GFIs, insert the phrase, except SSS, GSIS, PhilHealth, Pag-ibig, OWA Fund, Philippine Veterans Affairs Office Pension Fund, and other government social welfare entities.
We would like to ensure that the pension funds and the aforementioned funds would not be touched, Your Honor, to at least preserve this, because we have had experiences in the past where the hard-earned money of our people were lost.
That's the main reason, Mr. President, why we included OWA to ensure that the MIC will deviate from even entertaining the idea.
The Maharlika Investment Corporation, which will be formed eventually, can only touch the money of Land Bank of the Philippines, Development Bank of the Philippines, and other government financial institutions. Only individuals with no pending cases can occupy the MIC Board of Directors seat. And as part of the safeguards, Senator require a special MIC audit every 5 years. An MIF Oversight Committee from Congress will also oversee the MIC's spending of the 500 billion peso fund, which will be sourced from the Land Bank of the Philippines, Development Bank of the Philippines, Banco Central ng Pilipinas, and various government-owned and controlled corporations and government financial institutions. GOCCs can only invest in the MIC if cleared by the Governance Commission for GOCCs. Fine for violators run from 5 to 15 million pesos. Each MIC project must be announced on its official website, and any additional fund must be cleared by Congress. President Marcos also allays concerns on funding sources of the proposed sovereign wealth fund. Marcos says pension funds will not be used as a seed fund, although he sees nothing wrong with state pension funds investing to the Maharlika Fund.
We will not use it as a seed fund. However, if a pension fund, which is what pension funds do, is they invest. If the pension fund decides that the Maharlika Fund is a good investment, it's up to them if they want to invest in it. So, like any, not only a pension fund, but corporations. Mga fund, yan lang ang ginagawa nila, pinapalaki ng pera nila para mayroon silang may bigay. Like hey, GSIS, this is precisely what they've been doing. They're making sure they're very solid, that they're very stable, so that all the payments that they need to give out. So we have to differentiate those two things. But no, we will not use it as a seed fund.
National Economic Advisor Arsenio Balisaca welcomes the bill's adoption.
Not too worried about, you know, as we keep on saying, we have to grow the economy. And so even as debt increases, as a proportion of that debt of the economy, the debt will fall.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., meanwhile, is expected to present this to the people in July for his second State of the Nation address. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and House Speaker Martin Romualdez now calling for unity following weeks of drama over the alleged ouster plot at the House of Representatives. Romualdez made the call in his speech before he adjourned the first regular session of the 19th Congress. Now, the president's message of unity, meanwhile, came through a video message where he also thanked the lawmakers for their work.
Pursuant to our shared vision of a strong republic, leaders of major political parties in this August halls have expressed their unwavering commitment to work together for the passage of the pro-people legislative agenda of President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr.
Remain united, determined, and passionate. Be the voice of the people and fulfill your duty as servant leaders in your respective districts and provinces.
Earlier this week, several political parties reaffirmed their alliance with the La Paz CND, which Romualdez leads. Vice President Sara Duterte had faulted the party, citing political toxicity. Duterte's resignation came after a former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, another member of the La Paz CND, was demoted from Senior Deputy Speaker to Deputy Speaker. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department will assume the task of looking after Filipinos on death row overseas. Foreign Affairs Undersecretary Eduardo de Vega says the DMW will begin handling their cases in July. He told a House panel that most of the 82 Filipinos on death row overseas are in Malaysia. De Vega also says the Philippine government remains hopeful that Indonesia will spare the life of Mary Jane Veloso. The convicted drug mule was granted a reprieve by Jakarta in 2015 after appeals by the Philippine government. President Marcos Jr. previously said his administration is working to get a commuted sentence or a pardon for Veloso.
The Philippine Justice Department agrees to closely collaborate with the European Union Agency for Criminal Justice to fight transnational crimes. The commitment was made during a meeting at The Hague last week. Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla and Eurojust President Ladislav Hamran. The two officials agreed to outline cooperative working arrangements for investigating and prosecuting specific cross-border crimes. The Philippine ambassador to the Netherlands says both sides hope to prioritize the fight against the online sexual exploitation of children.
Four branches of the Philippine Commission on Human Rights conducting a probe on the cease and desist order against a Quezon City orphanage. The Social Welfare Department flagged the Gentle Hands Orphanage due to alleged violations, including overcrowding. Tuesday, some members of the agency visited Gentle Hands branch in Baliwag, Bulacan, but they were barred from entering the facility.
Nagkakaroon po kasi ng discrepancy doon sa actual numbers ng mga bata na na-rescue or kung ilan ba talaga ang nasa custody ng Gentle Hands. After pong nung transfer yung mga bata dito sa tatlong centers, doon na po lumabas na merong unaccounted na 22 na mga bata. Nag-dispatch po ng team yung aming regional office 3 sa doon sa Baliwag, Bulacan para sana nga i-account. Unfortunately, hindi po sila pinayagan na makapasok ng Gentle Hands. Pero tuloy-tuloy pa rin po yung investigation na gagawin namin dito.
Meanwhile, the CHR is also investigating claims of the presence of armed policemen during the rescue operations, which the DSWD denied.
Wala kaming mga baril. Wala kaming access sa baril, wala kaming access sa mga policemen. Maari silang nagtawag sa police. One thing for sure, hindi DSWD ang nagdala ng mga police. Ang aming dinala nung gabi na yon ay kulang-kulang 25 na social worker.